That looks good. It's starting to look more and more like a book.
Yes, it is.
Welcome to the fourth episode of the six-part miniseries of Making a Photo Book Dummy by the Rijksmuseum Creative. This series is inspired by the photographer Ed van der Elske. And in this lesson today, we're going to make spread, double pages, and we're going to decide our order of the photo book. Kathy, I see you have two gorgeous pictures laying on the table.
Thank you.
And these are going to be part of the book. And you have something that you stumbled upon with these two photographs.
Yeah, if I put them on one page or if I put them next to each other, it doesn't really fit.
Of course, you could pick one picture, but I think that's a shame because they're both very beautiful. What we could do is maybe mirror the image.
Okay.
Put them next to each other. So if you flip open the book, you have the shark swimming in the direction of the turtle and the turtle swimming back in the direction of the shark. So they're communicating a little bit more than if we would let them swim in the both in the same direction. Unless something else on the previous page is really interesting, but I think this is a very nice way to flip them through the pages. So
exactly,
we can start by pasting them on the sheets.
Mm-hmm. Taking the glue, the photo glue.
Yes. Kathy is using glue with a brush. And our dummy is going to be a sketch. So it doesn't matter if the photos are a little bit bubbly. But if you're doing this at home and you're making a dummy that is the real deal right away, I suggest that you use spray mount, because then you have a more evenly surface in your photo book. Gorgeous. Two beautiful spreads communicating with each other. A photo book obviously has pictures, but maybe you want to add some text.
Yeah.
And if you want to add text, then we have to think about that when we are designing the next pages, because then we have to leave space for the text. We can use a computer to do that and then print out the text, but we can also be inspired by Ed van der Elske. And what Ed does, Ed is literally drawing and scratching on top of the surface of his photographs. It's a nice way to experiment, and I was wondering if you would like to do that.
Yes, I would very much like to do that. I've never done that before, to put it on the picture itself.
Okay, yeah. Then we're going to do that when we finish the spreads, because then the photos are done and then we can spice it up a bit.
Yeah, okay.
These two photographs we also selected because they have a strong connection together. You can see the picture of her children leaning over a bridge, looking into the water. And as a viewer, you might imagine what are they looking at. And by placing the fishes on the next page, we can see what the story is about, what they're looking at. Earlier I mentioned that this one deserves a whole spread. And these two can go together.
Difficult decision.
And maybe you can find another suggestion, because we can place them on separate pages, but we can also do that. So we can place them on top of each other, and then we have an empty page. It could be a blank page, a white page, but we can also experiment with color. And I have a few options for you. So maybe you can pick a color and see what it does with your photograph. So that's a good choice.
Because of the red?
Yes, it's communicating back with the page. It's also the color of the flag of Japan, red and white.
So yes, yeah.
You can make a strong reference to the country that you travel to.
Yeah.
You're normally, when you make a photo book, you would make it on white paper, but you have endless possibilities. You can use all colors or patterns. Now we still have the other picture. We're going to use a full spread, but we can still experiment when we're placing the picture. So maybe you can leave a little space here, because the man here, he's leading them this direction.
Yeah.
So if you put him solo on this page, that means you have some space left here, but that's okay. So now he's really leading him over the pages, back into the past.
Yeah.
Maybe these photographs. I think think we can decide an order of the photo book. That's also an important part of your story. So we can clear everything to the side and then put all the spreads together.
Okay.
You have space for one more there?
Yeah.
So if you open your book, what is the first page that you want to see for your story?
I think this one, because this is so Japan. So you immediately know what the book is about.
Yeah, okay.
The Pikachu.
That's a nice one, because if you put them together, if you flip through the book, you have a full page, and then you go to a full page.
There's another one, yeah.
And then you have space. So that's a good choice.
I think this one.
Could be that one. But I suggest that we use a full spread, maybe. Because
okay.
Now we have, else we get the same trick over
again.
Okay. So we want the viewer's eyes to adjust to something else.
We will go to, I think, to the streets.
To the streets. We go out to the streets.
Followed by this one.
Yes. Very nice. So we have a very dominant color here. So maybe we need a little bit rest in our eyes. We're staying on the streets.
Yes.
There you go.
Then I would suggest this one, because it's the animal, mm-hmm. and we're going to another animal.
Yeah, and the kids, of course,
so
we have a double
repetition
in the story there.
Then I think this would be nice, the
yes, from aquarium. Water to water.
But then first the whale.
So first the whale.
Yes, then a turtle.
Yes.
And then we have two left. Mm-hmm. I think this one.
Yes.
It's also really Japan. And then we end the day or the book. Sleeping.
Yeah. So we start here from the temple through Pikachu inside a house apartment, out on the streets, and from the streets we go diving into the water with all the fish and the people, and then we end in our bed sleeping and dreaming.
Yes.
If this trip really happened or not. Good. I think we have a very nice order, and we're ready to finish the book up. In the next episode, we're going to focus on a good cover image. And we make up some titles experimenting with fonts and color. Thank you for watching, and see you next time.